Need admissions information? Need help to register for classes? Have financial aid questions? Or want to sign up for a walk-in counseling session? The Student Service Center is the place to go. The Student Service Center, located on the first floor of A Building at the Clock Tower entrance. You can follow them on Twitter at #LakelandSSC.
It's Mr. Fabulous, Jesse James Helsius from Mr. Fabulous and the Bad Boys, and you're listening to Lake Effect Radio. Make sure you check us out on Facebook and SoundCloud.
I found God on the corner of First and Amistad, where the West was all but one. All alone, smoking his last cigarette. I said, where you been? He said, ask anything. Where were you when everything was falling apart? All my days spent by telephone. Never rain. All I needed was a call that never came. To the corner of First and Amistad. Lost the man's cure. You found me. You found me lying on the floor. Surrounded. Surrounded. Why'd you have to wait? Where were you? Where were you? Just a little late. You found me. You found me.
Unfortunately, or fortunately.
Depending on how you look at it.
I mean, I like the fact that I got all my midterms done with, and I'm back, and I'm getting my grades back, and I'm going, yay, they're not horrible.
Yeah, it is the best feeling ever when you feel like you just totally failed a test, and you get it back, and you did, like, surprisingly well. It's like, hey,
yes.
Success.
Yes. I know that feeling. I had a teacher that I took last semester, and I swear, I felt like I was getting all the questions wrong on the test. Mm-hmm. And then when I got it back, all of a sudden, I was just like, wait a second. This is graded as a B. What is this? What is this nonsense?
What magic has been used here?
Exactly. But you know what? I'll take it.
So yeah, don't question it. Just let it happen.
Yeah. So did you have a good spring break?
I did. How was yours?
It was crazy hectic because, you know, I was working for most of it, and we actually had the shop closed that I worked at the week before, so we had a lot of stuff that we had to catch up on because, you know, we had to make everything fresh and keep up to date and get in early so that we could make everything, and it was real fun, and by fun I mean horrible because we were always low on stock.
Sarcasm.
We finally caught up. Yay! But it was very nice when I was like, all right, easy day, and oh yay, it's actually an easy day.
Yeah, weekend before last, I was at Cleveland Concoction.
Aw, yes.
That was a good time. Got to meet up with one of my old cosplay buddies again. You mm-hmm. know, he runs some panels there. Oh, words are difficult right now. Good goodness.
Okay.
But, yeah, so, and I got to introduce my friend to him as well. I had a friend who flew in from New Jersey.
Okay.
So we had a collaborating costumes mm-hmm. for the first day.
Yeah.
That was it. That was the only ones for the contest. But it was a lot of fun. That was only her second con she's ever been to. You know, I've been trying to mm-hmm. introduce her to the community, and she seemed to take to it fairly well.
Okay.
Which is always fun.
Yes. Introducing somebody to the con world is amazing.
Oh, it is so much fun.
When I went to Anime Expo this last year, back in July last year, we actually ended up, I was in a group, and we ran into somebody who was dressed as somebody from the same anime as we were,
mm-hmm.
and they were all by themselves, and we're like, hey, why don't you just, like, chill with us for a little while, because it was their first con, and they were like, I don't know what I'm doing, and we're just like, hey, chill with us. Just be with us for a little bit and enjoy it. And if you need to go somewhere, go ahead. But why not spend some time with us? You're awesome. Your costume's amazing. And you're the mayor. I mean, you're the mayor. So, Homestuck, the mayor.
Yeah. Yes,
he was the most adorable mayor ever. I'm guessing it was a he. It's kind of hard to tell.
You can't really tell, but still.
They were so shy, though.
Aww.
It was very mayor-like. It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, and just introducing people to the con world is awesome.
Oh, it is so much fun.
Yes, it really is. And
like, once you get them hooked on it, it's great.
Definitely. I'm burning up in here, though.
It is so warm.
Yes, it is. Alright, I was going to say, everybody outside is probably like, what are you talking about? It's freezing. What is with the ice that's been on the ground lately? I mean, it's been so warm.
Ohio can't make up its mind.
It really can't. It's thrown me off, because I was like, oh, look, we're done with snow. Everything's good. It's warm out. What is this white stuff?
The rule of Ohio is, don't ever get excited when there's a warm day in March. Like, just never. Never. Because there's a deceptively warm day that, hey, spring is finally here. You've got snow up to your butt then the next week.
Oh, goodness.
Like, that's what it is. That's Ohio for you in, like, a nutshell.
Well, that's just upsetting.
Very so. But,
oh, you know, I that's it. Peace out. I'm taking it back. I'm going to California where the sun shines. And a cold day equals 65.
See, that's a hot day here.
I know. I've noticed that recently where I've been just looking outside, and I'm like, oh, it looks pretty nice out. And I walk outside, and I'm like, yeah, it's so nice. Then I look at the thermometer, and it goes, it's 68 degrees. And I'm going, what in the world? This is supposed to be cold.
Welcome to the lake.
This is a very different feeling. My brain doesn't know what to do.
Yeah, but I mean, I guess you didn't grow up here, so it's not like, I'm used to this. It's like, no, it's one of those weird things.
Although I've noticed I've started dressing completely different.
Yeah.
I mean, I have the same basic staples that I used to have, but I'm always putting something like an undershirt on or leggings on underneath my pants. So I'm like, bundle, bundle, bundle. Oh, look how nice it is. Bundle.
Yeah. Whenever summer does hit, Ohio can't make up its mind there either.
Oh, goodness.
So it can't make up its mind whether it's a nice day that you can go out and enjoy it being like shorts or whatever and t-shirt and just comfy, or if it's going to be so humid and hot that if you go outside, you feel like you're going to drown. Like, yeah, it's like, Ohio does not understand how to weather at all. It's all like, what is this?
All right, that's it. Just peace out. I'm just moving somewhere else.
Just go to the middle of the country.
But then again.
Go to Kansas.
Then again, Ohio costs a lot less. So, you know.
It's because it's Ohio. Off. No one wants to live here. Like, what, 24 astronauts have come from Ohio. Something about our state makes people want to leave the planet.
That's good. Oh my goodness, that's hilarious. Do you know the stats on anywhere else, or just Ohio?
I just know Ohio because it's ridiculous.
That is a lot of astronauts.
Yeah, something about our state makes people want to leave the planet.
Or maybe Ohio just breeds people that have the higher level of intellect needed to be an astronaut.
They just, they grow up because they're like, I don't want to stay here.
I gotta get out.
Yeah, they go for it. They're just like, no, let's like shoot for the stars, literally. That's what it is.
No, let's shoot for the moon, because you know what? If you shoot for the stars, you'll just be wandering in space forever. So
let's aim it at the moon. Let's go there.
And let's not go into stuff about the aiming at the moon, because you know what? There is all sorts of issues that have happened with, like, actual science missions where people have tried to land things on the moon or other planets. And it's gone horribly awry because somebody did some little itty-bitty math wrong.
Oh, dear.
Either they just, like, totally crashed into the planet and the thing's destroyed, or they just kind of shoot past it, or...
See, this is why I wouldn't be allowed on any of those teams. I don't math very well.
Well, that's why everybody checks everything, like, 5 million times.
And then checks it again.
Yes, and then somebody checks that 5 million times.
And then you have another person to check that, and then still these little errors get through.
Yeah, I know. Oh, I was writing a program today for one of my classes, and it was a basic program type that just did simple computing. And so I'm going, all right, let's check the math to make sure I wrote the program correct. Enter in all these numbers on the computer or in the calculator. That number doesn't match this number. But I know the number that my computer is calculating is right, but the calculator is not. What is going on here?
It's like the most frustrating thing that ever happens, too.
Which is actually really hilarious, because we're supposed to prove the program wrong, not the other way around. But I know my program is solid, so I'm just like, no, the calculator's wrong.
It's like this calculator doesn't know how to calculate.
I know it's just doing what I tell it to, but, you know,
it's
not
wrong.
Doing it right.
It's like, you're doing it wrong, you're a disgrace to calculators everywhere.
Oh, yes. I have had so many people, though, tell me, computers are dumb, and a calculator is a computer. Believe it or not, computers are dumb. I know
it makes sense.
But, and we people are smart. But, you know, I keep wondering... Because I'm just looking at this. I'm like, I programmed this thing. I know it works. I just can't prove that it works because I can't do the simple math that it wants me to do.
I don't math good.
Yes. And speaking of mathing good. If you guys, just so you guys know, if you go get the calzone from downstairs at Breakers,
oh, dear.
And you get one of the large soft drinks, and just that, it adds up to a total of $6.66.
That's scary.
Every time. I've done it more than once, and I'm just like, I'm not gonna get a calzone and just a drink anymore, because this is
terrifying.
This is bad. Not that I'm like actually, I don't know, religious towards that or superstitious towards that, but it's just kind of like, this is a bad omen. It's literally telling me that this food is trying to kill me or something.
Well, sometimes it does taste like there's something funky in it.
Oh, let's not go there. Oh, but we will go to the fact that I asked one of the cooks that was working there, because mm-hmm. the calzones weren't labeled, what's the calzone today? And they tell me that it's spinach and artichokes. And I'm going, oh, yay.
That sounds good.
Sounds good. All right, so I get one. I take it, I buy it, go start eating it, I cut it open. I definitely didn't see any spinach, and it tasted like there was chicken in there.
What?
I don't know anything about artichokes being in there. It was like a chicken salad or something.
It's breakers.
So I was just going, it's food.
Yeah, at this point it's like, it's food. I'll eat it.
Yeah, okay. So, either way. We're going to listen to some Lindsay Sterling now, and this is her Phantom of the Opera mix that she does, and we all love Lindsay Sterling because she's just such a talented violinist.
Incredible.
And if you can, check out her videos, because you want to watch her, because she doesn't just play the violin, she dances.
She performs.
Like, it's a full performance that she does. All right, so I hope you guys enjoy. This is Lindsay.
Thank you. Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, mail, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick erase it, write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick rewrite it, plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag and drop it, zip, unzip it, lock it, fill it, call it, find it, view it, go ahead, jam, unlock it, surf it, scroll it, pause it, click it, cross it, back it, switch it, fade it, name it, read it, tune it, print it, scan it, send it, fax, rename it, touch it, print it, play it, watch it, break the logic, one more time. Like the legend of the phoenix, yeah. All ends with beginnings. Oh, it keeps the planet spinning. The force from my beginning. No.
Something that I really like, and I don't know, Pentatonix has made such a breakthrough into the mainstream world right now.
I applaud them. I think they're incredible.
As I say, a lot of groups have been doing a similar type things, but the fact that they're an a cappella group and mm-hmm. they're breaking through everything.
I see, and I've known about them for, like, the last couple of years they've been around, but they just are, like, coming into light.
Yes. As I say, they've been around for at least, I think, 4 years.
At least four.
And now they've just, like, become front runner for everything.
Yeah, like, the last 2 years or so, they have just really popped up. It's like, good for you guys.
Yes. Acapella is cool.
It is. And they do it with, like, such a talent. It's so good.
It's such style. And they have, like, their own feel to it, and it's just really amazing. But, yes, I don't know. I never know anything. What are we talking about?
I don't know. We did not, like, make a plan.
What are you talking about? Plans? We don't do
plans. Plans aren't things.
All right, that collective just sigh.
Yeah,
it's not very good for the air.
No. So let's see. How was your
spring break?
Did we talk about
that? We kind of talked about it.
We vaguely touched on it.
But yeah, I just kind of like.
You were real busy. Yeah.
It's over.
I don't know. It's kind of good to be back.
I don't know, yeah, it was nice having all the free time, but it sucked having all the free time, because I'm normally doing both work and school, and I said, shh, I'm not telling my boss that it's spring break. Of course, she knew anyways, somehow, but I'm not saying nothing. I'm not on spring break. What's this spring break thing?
I've never heard of that. What is this?
So I just kind of was like, all right, we're gonna see if we can get as few hours as possible and just, like, relax, enjoy this time, except for...
That didn't quite work, did it?
It really didn't.
The struggle, man.
Although, one of the things that I did do that I was very happy about was there was a pancake breakfast at West Geauga High School, and my little sister goes there, and it's right down the road from where I live. And I actually went over there, and I had pancakes. I went home. I enjoyed everything. And then I got summoned to go and help out. Which I actually love volunteering quite a bit. And it was great because I was just like, okay, well, let's just do this. And so we were helping out and ended up staying for the whole thing. And then we actually went and... My little sister and I went back yesterday to help out again, and it's great because, I don't know, my personality type or something, and everybody loves me, and I'm just like, yay, I love this, and so everybody's like, oh, you and your sister were such a delight, and blah, 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 and you were doing so great, and I'm just like, oh, I'm just doing what I'm supposed to do, so, you know, I'm just always loving being bathed in common. Who doesn't?
I don't know.
It was nice helping out and giving back to the community. Because, you know, volunteering events are really great for just, like, people in general. They're great for you if you go and volunteer. They're great for you if you go and just enjoy the event.
Yeah.
It's kind of one of those things where it's just everybody's going together to have this good, positive effect. And it's a nice way to spend your time.
That's one of my favorite things that we do with my 4-H group, is that we help out at, you know, our sponsor dinners, and we actually, we did, I think, two of the displays at the Farm Park's Haunted Hayride this last year. And we do car washes and stuff. It's a lot of fun to be able to help out and do stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's a good feeling you get, and then, like, it's even better when you can do it with, like, friends and stuff. It's just, it's a good time.
I was gonna say, I was helping out with the Haunted Hayrides as well, but I was, just one of the actors.
Oh, what group were you in? Or what, display were you at?
I was all over the place. I went two different days, because that's all I had time for, and I was a tree, a scary tree.
Aww.
And one of them, and then I was one of just, like, the builder block people for the other day.
Okay, my group that, like, because we split our club into two, the amount of people we had, and we had displays next to each other.
Yeah.
One group was at the Swamp Witch one, and I think there were only, like, not counting a mom or two, there were only, like, two girls in the group, and that was My friend Alex and I think. Mm-hmm. Or, yeah, I believe it was Alex. No, it was my friend Avery. Whoops. Sorry, guys. But my friend Avery and I. And our advisor, you know, he's like, oh, well, we got Swamp Witch here, and we have Sharknado. Okay. And Avery, you know, was immediately, oh, I want to be a witch, you know? And I'm like, I want to be a shark. Let me be the left shark. Come on, guys. Like, let me do this. My advisor just looked over, he's like, you don't want to be a witch? And I'm like, no, I want to be a shark. Like, who wants to be a witch? It's like, they're going to be warty, and you're going to have to wear, like, masks and stuff. And it's like, no, thanks. Because it got really, really, yeah. really hot in those costumes. Like,
well, yeah, but as I say, on the day, one of the days that I volunteered, it was, like, pouring rain, and there was some sleet.
That's awful.
And so I was like, don't mind me, I'm bundled up in this little tree costume. Look at all the layers.
Yeah, the Sharknado one was kind of fun. Uh-huh. It was hilarious, and the intro that the people on the tractor had mm-hmm. was just hilarious, poking fun at what there was Sharknado 1 and 2. Yeah. It's like, now here's Sharknado 3! It's like, oh, goodness. Oh, you had too much fun with this booth this year, didn't you guys?
That's another thing that I was thinking about, because we're talking about sequels and movies and things. I don't know why, but for some reason this morning I was thinking about Jurassic Park and Jurassic World and just that series. And I don't understand why people still pay to go see things like that. Because it's the same plot line. It's exactly the same plot line.
Well, Jurassic World is literally just like a remake of Jurassic Park.
Exactly. It's, okay, let's see.
All they're doing is making remakes anymore.
Yeah, okay. Really, we're gonna go, oh look, we're gonna scientifically make it possible so that we can create these creatures that shouldn't be existing anymore. Oh, look, now we're going to make them in mass quantities, and now we're going to bring people around them. Oh, look, something horribly went wrong.
And you're shocked by this? Why?
And now somehow the world is saved.
the plot of, like, every movie ever.
That's another thing. Spider-Man. I was watching Spider-Man. And
how many times
Spider-Man.
Has that been rebooted now? Like, they need to stop.
But I noticed something. In The Amazing Spider-Man, the first Amazing Spider-Man movie, because there's more than one now.
The fact that you have to clarify that.
At the very end of the movie, there's he's Peter Parker sitting in class, and his teacher was talking about plot lines for stories. And quoting somebody saying that there was only 10 different plot types ever written in history. And the teacher actually said, no, there's actually only one. And it's about finding yourself. And then I watched the Spider-Man movie, and of course the intro to the movie is actually Peter Parker talking about him, this story being about him finding himself. And I'm just going, they did that on purpose.
They did.
They had to have done that. And only somebody who would watch The Amazing Spider-Man and then Spider-Man in that order would notice it.
It's ridiculous.
But the fact that they referenced that. Although, I love Stan Lee's part in The Amazing Spider-Man. The mm-hmm. scene where he's just in the library and they're just duking it out in the background and he's completely clueless, just doing his job.
Mm-hmm. And it's just like, nope, I'ma just be over here, I'm gonna do my job, I'm not gonna pay attention to that at all, there's nothing going on. Shh. This is not a thing that's happening.
That's some really loud music, though, that he was listening to. Mm-hmm. Jeez, Stan Lee, you need to turn your music down. You're gonna go deaf.
So you're gonna hurt yourself there, sir.
I mean, I know that you're past your prime, but you still need your ears and your hearing, right?
Yeah, that's still important.
Wow, what have we come to?
I'm not quite sure where any of this was going, honestly.
Alright, well, we're going to cut to a commercial break. You're listening to Dork with We at 3 on Lake Effect Radio, and I hope you guys are enjoying. But we'll see you, well, we'll talk to you in just a bit. We'll be right back.
Textbooks on reserve at Lakeland Library. Select textbooks are not available for students to check out and use in the library. Donations of current textbooks to the textbook on reserve. Programs are encouraged from instructors and students. If your textbook is not currently available in the library, please contact your instructor to provide a copy of their textbook for the Textbook on Reserve program. For more information on the library-initiated Textbook on Reserve program, please call 440-525-7424.
Lakeland Community College is hosting Spring Clean and Go Green Rummage Sale Thursday, March 24th and Friday, March 25th from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Main Campus, 7700 Clock Tower Drive in Kirtland, Ohio, in the Athletic and Fitness Center Auxiliary Gym. The public is invited to shop thousands of reused treasures donated by Lakeland employees, sponsored by Lakeland's United Way Committee. This green event encourages college employees to reduce their personal items found during spring cleaning to be reused, recycled, all while raising money for charity. Proceeds will be donated to United Way Lake County, which serves our needs to improve lives in our community. In addition to the rummage sale, local vendors will be selling recycled and handmade goods and other items. The rummage sale items include toys, household items, sporting equipment, lawn and garden tools, new merchandise, baby gear, children's clothes, electronics, DVDs, jewelry, collectibles, games. For more information, contact Mary Brown at 440-525-7824 or mbrown at lakelandcc.edu.
Are you interested in a career in the business or IT fields? If so, come to the Business and IT Fair Tuesday, March 29th from 1 to 4 p.m. The event will be held in room A2100 on the second floor of A Building. This event is open to the public. Bring your resumes and dress professionally. This is your chance to speak with employers, obtain career information, and apply for full and part-time jobs. For more information, call 440-525-7222.
Be sure to watch us live on www.livestream.com/LakeEffect.
Grad Fest, Monday, April 11th and Tuesday, April 12th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. and 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Everything you need for graduation on May 14th. Pick up your cap and gowns or commencement tickets. Order graduation announcements. Order class rings at the Lakeland Main Campus outside the bookstore. The March Coffee with the Cops will be held Wednesday, March 30th at noon in A2 downstairs of A Building at the Police Department. This month's topic will be an open house and tour of the Police Department. Patrolman Corey Eisenberg will be showing their dispatch center, booking room, cruisers, RSVP by email ceisenberg@lakelandcc.edu by Wednesday, March 23rd if you're planning to attend. There will be light refreshments will be offered during this event.
Do you want to be a part of a team? That-
That song, though, that song.
Yep.
It's a very empowering song.
Everyone needs a good pair of red high heels.
I don't have a pair of red high heels.
I don't really walk in heels, but, you know.
Metaphorical red high heels.
Yes.
There we go.
Everyone, strap on them. The words. Strap on those red high heels.
How about put on those red high heels?
Yeah, that'd probably be better.
Or slip into those red high heels.
I like it. I like that one. That's a good one.
Feel empowered. Just be like, you know what? This is me. This is how I do. If you don't like it, get out.
Yes, and then you can hear that powerful click as you walk away.
All right. So what team are we?
Wildcats!
I win!
What team? Wildcats!
Oh, goodness. I've seen so many posts about stuff like that where somebody just says, what team are we, or what time is it, or whatever it is, and then they go, Wildcats, and everybody responds with that, even if it's, like, unintentional.
Even if it's not. Yeah, it's, like, it's just an automatic reaction.
What does that say about our childhood?
It says that there was way too much High School Musical in it.
We've all been brainwashed by High School Musical. That's what it says.
Like, no matter how hard you tried to get away from it, you just couldn't.
Oh, and you've seen the posts about how High School Musical 2, like, took 6 weeks to film, and most of the time was spent on this Bet On It scene.
No, I didn't hear about that.
Yeah, 5 days or something for Bet On It, and the whole movie took 6 weeks to make.
Ridiculous.
That's a lot of time on Bet On It. Although, I have to say, they did a pretty good job. It was very dynamic.
It's ridiculous.
Don't mind me prancing around this golf course.
Yeah, like, the whole thing's ridiculous, but I think that's what makes it just so entertaining as well, is just really, like, if you go back and watch it now, we're probably gonna be like, we found this entertaining. Like, why? Why did we do this to ourselves?
The question is, did you watch the Humu Humu Nuku Nuku Apawa Ah song?
What?
It was like a deleted scene, and...
Oh, dear. See, I was never the kid that wanted to own High School Musical. I had friends who had all the DVDs ever that had to do with it.
Oh, let's see if I can find it.
But it was just... Oh my goodness. I was never like, oh, I need this, and I need this, and I need this, and this is all High School Musical, and I need all of it.
Look at that.
What? How did... That's ridiculous.
It's a thing. We're gonna watch it, because you know what?
I've never seen it.
Wait. I have to introduce
it. It needs to be experienced.
Do you want the music video, or do you want just the lyrics?
Well, let's go for the music video. Let's have the whole shebang.
All right. I hope you guys enjoy this. It's Huma Huma Nuka Nuka Apawa. Enjoy.
Where are we going?
Please, Mr. Bolton. How long is this?
Watch your step. Insurance issues.
I'm supposed to have a date tonight.
The evening is young, and so are you.
Well, where are we?
Shh. Hold your applause till the very end.
Whoa. What the heck? Mr. Fulton?
A long time ago, in a land far away, lived a pineapple princess, Tiki. She was sweet as a peach in a pineapple way, but so sad that she hardly speaky. Still, if you listen well, you'll hear her secret wish.
Aloha, everybody. My name is Tiki. I long to free a truly remarkable fish. My sweet prince. Huma huma nuku nuku apawa'a. Makahiki malahini hu. Huma huma nuku nuku apawa'a. Ooh. I wanna waka 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 niki poo poo.
Dreams of a boy who is under a spell that has left him all wet and scaly.
I sing from my heart of the power of love, just a girl with a ukulele. Come to me, my sweet one, and be still. I'll grasp your tail and stroke each tentacle. bikini who? Hooma hooma nooka nooka apple wa ah. Waka waka Nikki poo poo poo. Now this is where we lean into the whole kabuki thing. The clouds turned gray and the big sky cried and the ocean had a fit. Ryan, where's my ocean? Then the wind went whoosh and thunder cracked and Mighty Mount Foo Foo spit. Mighty Mount Foo Foo spit.
They just made it in general.
It was kind of creepy, wasn't it?
Yeah. There aren't really words to describe it.
Yeah.
It was very little unsettling is a good word for it.
Obsessed.
Obsessed, definitely.
Creepy.
Uncomfortable.
Very. I'm glad they took it out of the final cut.
Yeah, like, that was just, the overall was a little,
yeah, really.
No thank you.
It makes me wonder who came up with that.
Yeah, that's another good one. Who decided that this was a good idea to make it? And then after they shot it, it's like, oh, wow, this was a bad decision. Let's not put this in the movie.
I mean, I'm thinking whoever decided to... that made the final cut and said this is not going to be in it is probably one of the best parts of that production team.
Oh, yeah. Probably had the most sense. Like, you know, let's not do this. Let's not include this.
Mm-hmm.
Because that might be a little traumatic.
Just a little bit.
And
very positive enforcement on creepy stalker tendencies.
Yeah, and there was a... so much sequin. Lots of sequin.
Who designed that outfit?
Way too much sequin.
It was very scary. All right. Well, that is the end of our show. I hope you guys enjoyed listening to Dork with me at 3 on Lake Effect Radio. This is DJ Sparkles.
And DJ Jackie Blue.
All righty. We'll see you guys next week. Have a great day.
Textbooks on reserve at Lakeland Library. Select textbooks are not available for students to check out and use in the library. Donations are